log report. It's the December 31st, 2021. Time index is 12:52 in the morning. I haven't slept much. It's off and on since the last one. Last one was dealing with 12:30. This is dealing with 12:31. I think it was appropriate for me to get up just like a fool with the point on the air, get this log going. I guess we're going to be ringing this year out in less than 20 some odd hours, I'm figuring. And already online that they're celebrating New Year's Day in different portions. They count down to their celebration. And I'm not looking forward to it. The thing is, what I'm not looking forward to is Rosemont turning into a damn war zone. Now, thank God, since Christmas, it's been quiet. But I felt this tension outside building. They're ready to write. They're really to rip it up. Why can't we have the year just gradually pass by without any action? Without any noise, without any tolerance, without any of this going around. And the problem is we can't. It's not gonna happen. So for right now, I just have to deal and cope with what's going on right now. Yeah, I'm nervous. Yeah, I'm a little bit apprehensive of what may or may not happen. I'm a bit out of it. I'm not quite sure how to deal with it, to tell you the truth. I'm doing a hell of a lot of these things, trying to do some soul searching, what I can do, what I can't do, what my past is like, and what my screwed up head is like these days. Because of the COVID creeping into our lives, decimating it, that's right. Mask mandates. If you haven't got vaccinated, you need to get vaccinated. Prevention from dying. This bug. I had tried to talk about a bug, and I had YouTube pull the damn plug on me because I wasn't saying it factually. And I got a bad mark on it. How's that for having a 2021 mark on you? I say that about the masks because all around my damn domicile, these damn things are floating around on tables and on stands and packages. Sure thing for me to get is another stabbing. And for me, it's going to be about a couple of weeks from now, less. About 10 days and some odd hours. I'm doing the countdown. So I step on campus in Antelope Valley College, Lancaster, California, and feel utterly lost. Before they did the reconstruction, before they planned on any of this, I was feeling quite new for an older fort, walking on the campus for the first or second year. Actually, for the first year, but first or second semester, trying to get and feel my way around the place. It was straightforward for some classes, anyway. Convoluted for others, I guess. Comparing it to the college campuses that I traveled through and went through, I think I prefer Antelope Valley because more I should have been able to navigate my way on this place. And for a while before they did the reconstruction, I was. Comparing it to Pierce College out in Winnetka, California, which is right next to Woodland Hills, California. In the neighborhood of the park itself. Part of the Los Angeles Community College District. Sandwiched in the west end of the San Fernando Valley. And it took up a huge chunk of swath of area. It was technically made as an agricultural college, teaching you to find things, teaching you agriculture, not to mention livestock. Actual livestock. Moles, Brahma moles, and a few other kind of moles. They'd have the rodeos, long time ago. They would have farmer stores, farm store, basically. Their own version of a farmer's market. They would have Christmas trees sold. They would have Halloween hogs on the property. I mean, the thing expanded about a block, a little larger than a block. Two or three blocks. And it would be a campus that people would have to walk like crazy unless they had bikes that could bike up trails and bike up the hills. And it offered a spectacular view for the Performing Arts Building area of the San Fernando Valley. They had a few classes up in the hill that they had and oversaw much of the valley on the west side and showing east past certain areas. It was Kodak moment. If I could go back over there again, I probably would try to take pictures, but I don't know if I'd be worth it or not. Back then, '80s, I mean, hell, if I had a Kodak camera, or just a disposable camera, so I would have been taking pictures of the whole place. I missed the cafeteria. Far end of the cafeteria. Right next to the dilapidated Lot C on the ground. Their parking area looked like it was a bomb center. Craters all over the place, cracks all over the damn foundation. Students every year, every semester, kept bitching and griping to the board of trustees and the campus, not to mention to the campus president, and then also to the LA Community College District. Get that campus fixed. We're paying the tuitions. How come you ain't doing this? One year after the other year. Promises made by the student, by the faculty. Hardly ever. The bit marches. I remember back in the 80s for this one. Between 85 and 87, I had about enough. Marches going up and down their main area. Their services were scattered throughout the campus. I mean, it wasn't concentrated. I mean, you expect maybe to have an administration over here and then everything else would be classroom, but no, scattered. I saw the campus decades later when I came back to get the transcripts. My brother and I had traveled over to the campus and parked in the redesigned area. Now, keep this in mind, back in 1994, we used to live in San Fernando Valley as well. So, geography didn't change that much, but architecture changed drastically. and especially the places that I used to go to. Stores, malls, places, schools, campuses, everyone got hit. So it's no wonder that there had to be some redesigning of the campus over at Pierce College. But some of the buildings were intact, the rest of them they had to rebuild. And they rebuilt to make it more 21st century. Apparently they had some bond issues and redesigned some of their areas that was supposed to be thorough walk fairs became buildings in their area. Redesigned the walk throughs. They kept a performing arts building. And but everything else was changing down there. Everything had to be up to 21st century specs so they could keep up with the modern technology. The same problem that Antelope Valley College had. Some of the buildings are still old, they still need to be redesigned, and a few others are up to specs. So they're still working on it. Looking at the campus and going through the process that they had over there, I felt old, I felt ancient, I felt like, where the hell am I? Where I was at a college that I was no longer going. I mean, I may have claimed it for about a couple of years, but that was it, but I didn't feel part of the place. Thought I had. The cafeteria that they had right next to a dilapidated parking lot. The parking lot was all smooth. No cracks, but there was, they'd patch them up. The cafeteria was moved to different areas. Different building was there. They also had a student services building, and that was gone. Looking back on the Google Maps and then looking at the other maps they had of the place. It's amazing how what changes they've had done on the campus that I can barely recognize anymore. For the gym areas. So it no longer became a campus of my old home. It was an alien place that I barely recognized. I'm not quite sure if I can fit into that place or not. But this is a problem when you're an old person, isn't it? Going back to something and trying to take care of a long lost dream. That when you actually face the reality of it, you feel like too much time has passed by. There are some people will be screaming their heads off at this point. I'll be saying, what are you talking about? I'm talking about too much time passing by when the thing should have been taken care of a long time ago when it wasn't. During a time when I was going over to Pierce College, I was a different person altogether. I was a different kid. Problem is, I didn't understand it one bit. I was immature. I didn't have perspective. I didn't have context. I didn't have anything. Worked my ass off little jobs here and there to pay to get into the college, to get into the administration fees, and finally admit for a class or two. And then the fun part was trying to get the damn books. Exactly very cheap during that time either. Expensive as hell. Students can complain about how expensive a textbook can be. Especially the new ones that keep coming off the press. And the older ones have a little less value to them. partitions, but they still have the same organ. But the neutrophilic ones, and very few students can afford the new books. The new books would be, one new book would be just a reserved copy in the library for people to look at and take photographs of, and photocopy if they need to. But when you have cell phones, take as many pictures as you can. I did that myself. Yeah, at least that way I have the material, hopefully visibly ready, so I can take a look at it. Same material that was being covered by the same professor, who chose the same textbook for the students to use. So it was passed off from one student to another student to another student to another student. Other books had to be new. God's store was kind of cramped. The second one we got here, they tried to space things out as much as they could, and now they had to redesign them more because of the damn viral infestation they have. The library actually had a living tree in it. After a while, it's like, yeah, they got a tree in here. Just watch out for the damn sound. We had to laugh. We had to cry. We had to say goodbye. We had to say goodbye to a lot of things. Sessions have been since losing family a long time ago. It seemed like the pain and the grief had doubled up on itself each year to the point where I can't even recognize it anymore. I don't know what's going on. I'm going to be celebrating a potential year that may or may not be the greatest damn thing ever. And I'm going to have to deal with it. But I'm not looking forward to it either. I'm like this. I should be sleeping. Sleep. Because something keeps bouncing me out of that damn dream. And I'm still sleep deprived. least 4 hours of it. Not a few minutes at a time. So I know there's a clock ticking inside of me that's telling me something's going down the pipeline, and I don't know what the fuck's going on. It's pissing me off. As nice as this shirt is right now, I gotta do something that's gonna piss me off even further. Taking the damn thing off because I don't want to use it as a damn sleep shirt. I'll show you my old sleep shirt if I can. Despite the underlining of the stuff we're carrying forward from last year, we're still dealing with the same old stuff as we are. We're just making different shirts, we're making different window dressings, and I'm surprised this particular shirt's a 4X and it stretches. The material's a lot different than the other shirt I've got. Get up, I'll show you. Without all those damn holiday shirts, without the holiday festive theming in there, but the reality is, it carries forward all the junk, all the garbage, all the crap. Everything moves forward. It's like getting into a flood. Carrying forward all the crap from everywhere else. And despite the time shift, it doesn't matter. It's still flowing forward. That's how my life is feeling right now as it is. And I have to deal with it.
Yeah, if you don't mind.
See if I can hit that sack and get some sleep. I'll see you in a few hours.